As a tribute to the late Vice President Salvador Laurel, a museum will be launched in his honor in San Pedro, Laguna. Caroline Howard reminds us of the Marcos opposition leader and his family and friends who will mark his 84th birth anniversary on Sunday.
Born with politics in his blood, Salvador Doy Laurel is credited for helping unite the opposition against President Ferdinand Marcos. He founded the United Nationalist Democratic Organization, or UNIDO, the main voice of the opposition in the 1980s.
He wanted to follow the footsteps of his father, who wanted democracy back. And he probably thought that the people needed to be enlightened. Most of our leaders then were out of circulation. Some were in jail, some were abroad. And so he did it on his own. And he would get up on the truck, have a loudspeaker, and then he would tell them that they have to fight for the democracy.
With his political lineage and love for country, it was a fight that took Doy from being champion of the masses in his law practice to the Senate halls and to finally pursuing a bid for higher office. When Senator Ninoy Aquino was slain in 1983, Doy resigned from the Batasang Pambansa. And at the time that called for a rallying figure in the fight against the ruling power, Doy chose to be a statesman, giving way to the Aquino widow's bid for the presidency in the 1986 snap elections.
Well, he thought that if they split, if they both ran, that would be a terrible, terrible thing, because then the opposition would be weakened. He remembered that his father had given way to Magsaysay. He was the most probable candidate of the Nationalista at the time. But he felt that Magsaysay had a good chance of winning because he had been cheated before. He said, if my father could do it for the sake of the country, then I can do it too. So no matter what I said, didn't matter because he had made up his mind.
Martial law opposition icon and confidant to Doy in the Senate, Eva Estrada Calo believes he would have made a good president.
Doy was not in politics for himself and took a role. He took sides. He stood for something. If Doy was given more leadership, I think he would have worked more for the country.
The man and what he stood for were the same. The man was an idealist. If he had been given the chance, maybe the country would be better off now, as he had dreamed it to be.
In 2005, Celia paid tribute to Doy with their version of history. Ahead of his 84th birth anniversary on November 18th, the Laurel family continues to honor his memory, this time with a museum in the family estate in San Pedro, Laguna.
He loved nature, and I thought that since he loved the place and he used to meditate there, he built a chapel there, that it should be kept in his memory. He had a little museum there of his public life. I amplified, I arranged the garden around because he loved the garden. So this is in memory of him, and hoping that his memory will not fade.
The Doy Laurel Museum celebrates the life of the man who, despite having missed the chance to lead the country, still inspires Filipinos with his fight for democracy. Caroline Howard, ABS-CBN News.